Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game, and you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
The way with the four-minute offense is just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
Well, certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
First and 10, here's Levis. And Levis tosses his third interception of the game. Jordan Brooks with it. And the Vikings are right back in this football game. Sets them up with an opportunity to erase this fourth quarter deficit. Now, this series could very well determine our outcome. After the turnover, it's Tua. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's right. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it'll be second down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Throwing the out route, incomplete. That's Chandler. And he's going to be taken down about the 33. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. They'll come up now. This is second and long. Now Tua. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Amari Hooker. And the Titans will take over possession here up at the 44. They'll take over first down 10 at their own 44-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Again, it's Henry.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Now second and 5. And Levis going to change the play. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And he gets it down to the 32. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Point after here coming up. And the lead is up to 14.
Makes the score Titans 42. Vikings 1 game.
There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Here's first and 10. Now Tua. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Here's first down. Throwing Tua. Looking for Campbell downfield. And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time has run out now on this game. Well, this was a fun.
I ain't tripping, this is easy. Easy. Got him excited to meet me. Meet me. I got diamonds, you got CZs. CZs. Wake up, get to it, and repeat. Repeat. Hey, I ain't hearing nothing, hey, to say. Let them talk about it. My whole crew is about 100 deep. Gotta walk around it. I kill it, and then I walk away. Put the chalk around it. I just get low key and watch them talk about it. Talk about it. I'm in New York and we finna get loose. Squeeze the big apple and give me the juice. Don't wanna talk, I just do what it do. My alter egos can fill up a room. Hop in the flight, take a trip to Peru. Yeah, hop in the whip, they're dismissing the roof. My woman a fire, just look at my boo. I'm no money, I'm feeling like Bruce. Ooh, 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 ooh. I don't need much, a billion do. Ooh, 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 ooh. Breaking the hearts and breaking the rules. Ooh, 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 ooh. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. I ain't tripping, this is easy, easy. Got him excited to meet me. Meet me. I got diamonds, you got CZs. CZs. Wake up, get to it, and repeat. Repeat. Hey, I ain't hear nothing, hey, to say. Let them talk about it. My whole crew is about 100 deep. Gotta walk around it. I kill it, and then I walk away. Put the chalk around it. I just get low key and watch them talk about it. Talk about it. Every week I got a mission to get it. Hop on a flight and then finish in business. I'm sitting in business, just look at the ticket. A traveling man, I'm switching the pivot. Why would I talk about it when I live it? I know that you live it, I know that you mad. Putting up numbers and flipping the digits again and again and again. Well, you get it. Elevate and enjoy the saga. Better pay, give me more of them dollars. Still on the grind, ahead of my time. My yesterdays are your mananas. Trip to Hawaii to bust out the haka. I bust out the haka, I bust out the ooh. When there's nothing to do. Never been capping, you know that it's true. True, 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 true. Haters are climbing your river like boo, 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 boo. Breaking the hearts and breaking the rules. Boo, 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 boo. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. I ain't tripping, this is easy, easy. Got them excited to meet me, meet me. I got diamonds, you got CZs, CZs. Wake up, get to it, and repeat, repeat. Hey, I ain't hear nothing, hey, to say. Let them talk about it. My whole crew is about 100 deep. Gotta walk around it. I kill it, and then I walk away. Put the chalk around it. I just get low key and watch them talk about it. Talk about it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, alright, I got him. T-Stead, look, look, yeah. Full court press or full blitz, we going all out. It don't matter any time of day, I came to ball out. We TCG, never duck a smoke or any call out. Better be ready to go to war until we fall out. 0 to 60 like Ludacris, we came to roll out. You know I gotta get my checks, so please don't make me hold out. Bust down Cuba in the summer day, I make it cold out. They was hot then, now they cold now. Left wrist dripping, I got it froze now. Went from rags to riches, take the clothes now. My name heavy all across the globe now. We ain't playing HBCU, I strike up the band. Stomping on them like a cute dog or alpha man. In Miami, hard rock jumping like a rock band. You know me, I love my green and teas like a Packers fan. I'm a player, gotta keep it player, how the game go. With the steppers, I ain't gotta tell them, they just train to go. Calling plays and I'm calling shots like the head coach. First class, so we take the private, we don't do coach. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now.
Dirty, yeah, you know we global with it. Black fit, limo tint, you don't know who in it. Whole team having motion, world know who in it. I
coming over here and little bit of the other dudes know for dissing. Big motion, boy. Big vibing, boy. Tell her, pipe that loud talk down, cause they ain't making noise. Yeah, homie, we them boys. Who they be preaching about?
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Today, we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap, as it'll be the Miami Dolphins taking on the New England Patriots.
Chad Ryman to kick off for the Patriots.
The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. Throwing first play is Lance. They'll swing this out wide. Here's A-Chain. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. And now the first run for Devon A-Chain. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 and the 34. This defense for the Patriots, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, 3 of them in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
Now Lance looking to change it up. They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. Got a man, it's Brown. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's a lot of loss on the play. And that'll bring up 4th down. Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play design was.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on 4th down. They run for it. A-Chain. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A big roll of the dice on 4th and 1, but it pays off. They convert.
I'm laughing because I'm not so sure I would have made this call. I'm not so sure I would have said, yeah, let's go ahead and get this one, especially at this point of the game. But give him credit. He had a feeling and carried it through.
Yeah, that's one where you think, okay, if you're down 2 minutes left, the ball's near midfield, you go for it. But at this stage, at that part of the field, but like you said, it worked. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a 1st down. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
But that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1.
Yeah, able to give one man the slip there as he works his way forward for about 3. But you look at this Patriots defense, and they played well against the pass, currently ranked 7th in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the...
There he goes, right side. Down the sideline he goes. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Dolphins get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
The Patriots take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
We are in it to win it.
Keep the ball. keep it together.
On the ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least two first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
From the 25, here's second down and eight. Levis sets up to throw here. And that's going to be incomplete.
Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Back to throw, it's Levis. He's got his target, that's complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. That one goes for 29 yards on third down. First and 10, it's Pierce. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The Patriots at 5-4 now on the year. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
Levis now on second down. Got a man, it's Tyquan Thornton. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 31-yard line. A nice pickup there, 10 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Levis. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it in. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Are you kidding me?
So a good challenge there. The look pretty conclusive. The feet were in, and it's a completed pass. They'll run here with Pierce. And he gets it a little bit closer. He takes it from the six inside the five to the four.
You get down near the goal line, you need to start enlisting the help of all 11 guys on the defense. And that's a nice job there by the cornerback, squaring his shoulders and coming in to make the tackle.
Second and goal from inside the five. In motion right is Davis. Here's Pierce. And he gets halfway there from the four to the two on a gain of two.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They'll run for it with Pierce. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Damian Pierce. His fifth rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Extra point by Rylan, up and good. And we are tied at seven. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
The Dolphins take over at first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
It's Dolphins football here as we begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a second and four coming up. Chain here, they stay on the ground, and he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. Lance now to throw. Open man is Hill. He's got it, and he will have the first down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. They get six on the pickup there as the drive continues. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field defensively. Make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
And Lance's throw caught by his receiver, Hill. And he'll go out of bounds after taking a little further down inside the 40. It'll go down as a gain of six, and that will bring up second down.
Here we go.
Man open left side is Brown. Call it a gain of a yard, and that's going to bring up third and two. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Now Lance wants to change him up. They'll run for it with A-Chain. That is not going to be any help as they dump it behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Dolphins going to bring the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. And the kick is good. He needed a little help there from the crossbar, but the carom goes his way. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. So a favorable bounce that time, to say the least, and he's able to convert the field goal there from long distance.
Yeah, the guys behind the end zone didn't need to hike the net up for this one. That thing was a dying quail, but he finds a way to boink it off the crossbar and make it drop through.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They currently sit one game over 500 thanks to their victory a week ago. Yeah, Charles, they've been really an up-and-down team all year. Do you think that they have enough to get into the playoffs?
Well, you did mention they've been up and down all year, so to me, it depends on what week you catch them. When they're at their best, I think they're definitely playoff-worthy. But to me, they haven't been able to...
Well, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Well, CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Lance. And he overshot. shot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Let's go now. Second and 10. And Lance going to throw. That's out to Hill, right side complete. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Now Lance again. That one complete to Hill. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. Sean McDermott didn't hesitate. They'll go for it on fourth. They'll try and run for it. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. You're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Levis now on first and 10. Uncorks one for Davis. All wide open, complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Gabriel Davis, 62 yards. And the Pats are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. Extra point by Rylan, up and good. And the lead is now 14-10. Back out is the kicker, Rylan, and he'll send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Oh, an absolutely filthy joke. He's got some space now. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin first down.
A gain of 13 yards.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Shot, 17. Ran, cycle. Ready?
Lance looking to throw it. Flush to his right. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
Here's a second and five. A give up the middle to A-Chain. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Third down, here's A-Chain. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up third downs in the top five in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I'm guarantee you, it started in the offseason. Third down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
Here we go, here we go. Drill, 52. Ready?
And they fake the handoff. Now Lance. And going deep for Hill. It's caught at the 10. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. First down now, but that clock rolling. Throwing now is Lance. He dumps it off to A-Chain. And here he'll get it down to the 7. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs. And they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Dolphins going to take their second timeout. As the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Throwing is Lance on third down. Touchdown, Dolphins! Tyreek Hill with career touchdown number 96. He joins Eric Dickerson on the all-time list. And the Dolphins will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now 17-14. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
That one good for 13 and a New England first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
First and 10, here's Levis. He'll air this one out deep for Davis. And incomplete on the deep ball.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
Levis looking to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10. Working from the gun, here's Levis. A short throw taken in by Conklin. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. The one final shot before the half. Here's Levis. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far and second down. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, and we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Marcus Jones, a return man. Well, a good-looking return set up here. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. New England with a first down as they begin the drive.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Levis throwing again on second down. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
That's a gain of eight. Brings up third and two.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. It's a gain of eight, and it'll wind up moving the chains.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. On first down, Levis. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way, way out there, but it'll be third down. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
That's good.
Levis looking to move him around a bit. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that one going to come up short. Low throw.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Second down, here's Levis. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Pierce will try to pick it up. But he's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. Levis to throw it. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give them seven there on the first down carry. And they're going to speed things up here. Again, it's A.J. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Come on, set.
On first down, Lance. Got a man, it's Brown. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Now they'll change things around before the snap. Lance now on first down. The throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
On second down, a run by H.A. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. And quickly, they get to the line. H.A. now up the middle. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. 64 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries. Throwing on first down is Lance. They complete it to Hill. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down. To throw, it's Lance. He'll get it once more into the hands of Hill. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of five.
A gain of five brings up second and five at the 24-yard line.
From the 24 now, here's second down and five. They go back to the ground game with A-Chain. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. Out of the gun, here's a give to A-Chain. Able to slither by, and he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Foxborough. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Lance now on first down. That to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
Here's second and 10. Here's Lance to throw it. Throw left side complete. That's Brown. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. And Lance now to throw.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the five here as he's out at the six. So the completion good for just three. And that
He'll go for it. Lance rolling to his right. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Trey Lance, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Dolphins get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit. Levis to throw on first and 10 here. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense, they spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's Levis. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. And they're able to convert on 3rd with a solid gain of 23. So now 1st and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 46. Again, it's Levis looking to throw it. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
Back to the air on 2nd down, Levis. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
This offense so far on 3rd down, they've been excellent. 6 for 7. This is 3rd and 10. Now Levis. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it 1st and 10 at the 41-yard line. Now Lance. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. A big play there. 59 yards. And the Dolphins are about to make it 4 straight as they add to this fourth quarter advantage. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. On the return, Marcus Jones from the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
The Patriots take over 1st and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
New England with a 1st down as they begin the drive. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best of the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
Levis uncorks one for Davis. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And now the football is going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line.
On first and 10, here's Lance.
Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
They're certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Well, they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be fourth down. Sanders' kick is good.
So the starting field position was terrific following the surprising turnover on downs, but the end result, only 3 points.
Simply stated, I think you have to look at that as a missed opportunity.
And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Patriots take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. See if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision.
And this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Patriots. Danny Gray, his first touchdown on the year. And the Patriots have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that cuts this lead down to 13. So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Ready, ready.
Here's Lance. Throw out wide is incomplete.
So many things have to go right for any passing play to work out. Quarterback has to understand the defense, deliver an accurate ball. Receiver has to concentrate and bring it in. Somewhere along the assembly line, something was off with that one.
Lance looking to throw it. Man open left side is Brown. And he'll be out right at the 35. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. This will be caught once again by Brown. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think you continue to do so.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column.
From the 48-yard line, here's second and four.
And Lance going to throw. That'll be caught by Hill.
And Hill is going to have a Dolphins first down as a tackle made at the 42.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Over the middle, complete. That's Hill. A solid stiff arm. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. So first and 10 now from the 30. And the Dolphin first down.
Now Lance again. He's got Brown on the out route complete.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Throwing now is Lance. His throw caught at about the 5.
And the Dolphins are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll look to throw again. They'll buy some time right.
That one tipped and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively. It's second down.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Brown. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And this brings up a third and goal.
All right, partner, I wasn't good enough to get this done, but I played with plenty of guys who did. When they spotted wide receiver screen and they got to the football fast and blew the whole thing up, the same result as we just saw usually happened. No gain.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. A great effort there. With now 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns.
And the Dolphins add on to their fourth-quarter lead, and they are on their way to improving to 8-2.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 40, right around the 39. So solid starting field position.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel.
And that is going to officially draw the curtain on this one as the last throw intercepted.
Picked up by Xavien Howard.
Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ball game.
Nobody do it better than me, not incredibly. I do this competitively, ineditably. These falling silent when I walk up in the building. Worry about their future like I'm here to snatch their children. That line was brilliant. How I'm not already in the millions? Am I not the picture of resilience? Why they test my patience? Hyping all this lane. No one got a brain, they just be liking all the same. Is this what the I
comment on industry games. I'm convinced that nobody is speaking my language. I'ma get it, so listen close when I say this. After every feel stainless. I can make a fiend go. Everything I wrote gon' smoke, so dangerous. I can make an Einstein feel brainless. But look on the bright side, hope yield changes. I'ma get it started, please give me a pardon. Cause this the type of beat that get the whole crowd marching. Time to shut it down, we made the whole town Spartan. I'm from outer space, so all my homegirls marching. It's about to get critical, this moment is pivotal. Here to feed the streets that say my influence umbilical. We gon' make it grimy, devil get behind me. Told you I'm the best, I done said it with my chest. So for real, nobody try me.
Down in the new town already.